Welcome back. This is Unit 6 of Programming Languages, and the story thus far is that we started with a big web page that might contain embedded JavaScript, and we did lexing or lexical analysis to break it up into a list of tokens. And once we had that list of tokens, we did parsing to check those tokens against a formal grammar and produce a parse tree. More recently, we've learned how to do interpreting to walk up and down a parse tree with an environment and figure out what the final result is supposed to be. We often call that meaning or semantics. In this unit, we're going to put that all together to build a unified web browser. And it's going to require all the tricks that we've learned up to this point, including things like how to debug or what can go wrong if you interpret a program with an infinite loop. Let's talk about the architecture for our web browser. Just as engineers or architects that build buildings in the real world like to have blueprints or plans or some notion of how that design is going to come together, we try to do the same thing in software engineering. We want to have a software architecture, a list of major components, and a design that incorporates all of them. Our first step is to find our web page and lex it and parse it until we have an abstract syntax tree. Most commonly, our HTML interpreter will walk over the abstract syntax tree that we got from the parsing, and it may find elements in there that are embedded JavaScript, so then we'll have to call the JavaScript interpreter on them. In most cases, at some point, the JavaScript code from the user will call write or document write, and that's that function that says, if I'm in JavaScript, display this on the resulting web page. Because the meaning of a JavaScript program that calls write is that that text should be displayed, we'll definitely want to store all of the text from write so that we remember to include it in the web page later. Eventually, the JavaScript fragments will be done executing and will be back to the HTML interpreter, which will have received all of those strings from write, and it will take them plus all of the normal HTML elements and call the graphics library to make a pretty picture of them. Eventually, at the end of the day, we end up with an image of the web page, and that's what we wanted from our simple web browser.